and welcome to another edition of Dishing with Dorothy, where today we're going to talk about something that's all the rage, charcuterie and charcuterie boards. One of the reasons that we're here today at North Country Charcuterie here in Columbus is that for the first time at the Ohio State Fair, we're going to have a charcuterie board competition. That's going to be on August 5th. The entries have been amazing. Please join us on that day to watch the competition. And Duncan and team will be there as part of the judges. So with that, I'm going to introduce my friend Duncan. He's going to tell us all about North Country Charcuterie.
Wonderful. All right. Well, thanks so much for coming out. Yeah, we're happy to host you here at North Country Charcuterie. You're absolutely right. In our opinion, when it comes to assembling a charcuterie board, the meat has to be front and center. And we do primarily make cured pork products, so salami and chorizo and bacon and things like that. Recently, we've also started to launch some beef, cured beef products as well, and I'll talk a little bit about that as we go through. So we source 95% of our ingredients from the state of Ohio. Most importantly, we've talked about the pork. The pork we source direct from a second generation hog farm down in southern Ohio. We get that directly from the farm, and then for the beef, we also get that from Ohio farms. And you know, we tried to partner with a lot of different Ohio makers as well, cheese makers, wine makers, as you talked about, spice makers, and things like that. So when you're assembling a charcuterie board, of course, you gotta have a nice looking platter. And you know, of course, you could just put meat on a plate and call it a day.
Sure.
But we wanna have a little bit more fun with that, you know, create some, put some artistic spin on the whole thing. And so what we do is when we're assembling a charcuterie board is we start with the meat. We always talk about the meat needs to be front and center. What I'm going to start with first, actually, is our herbed Wagyu brisola.
Wow.
You can see it's thinly sliced here.
Yeah.
That's Ohio-raised Wagyu. We do a dry cure of juniper, rosemary, thyme, salt, and pepper. It stays in our drying room for about 3 months, and then we sell it both whole and pre-sliced in these pre-sliced packages you can see here.
So now, Duncan, here at your store, at your establishment, you can do what? Purchase a pre-made charcuterie board? You can purchase the individual products?
That's a great question. So you can purchase the individual products and then take that home, slice it up, and make your own charcuterie board. On our website, northcountrycharcuterie.com, we actually have pre-assembled kits. Where it's we expertly pair one salami and one cheese and one other Ohio-made accoutrement, like a mustard or a jam or something like that. And then there's some also instructions on there, some tips and tricks on how to assemble a charcuterie board. And we can ship all of those nationwide. They make great gifts around the holidays.
Yes, that's great. Okay.
Yeah. So something that some people may have already seen on Instagram are some people call them salami roses. Or we're gonna do a brisola rose. So you can take a wide-mouthed cup and then you layer or kind of drape the meats around the edge of the cup. And so we're kind of, you see I'm kind of shingling the meats there on the outside. And we're gonna drape it around. And when it's all finished, we're actually gonna flip it over and it won't look perfect just yet. We'll do a couple of other things to prop it up and to make it look even more like the brisola rose, like I mentioned. So we've got the meat kind of draped around the cup,
yes.
And then we're gonna quickly plop it over. And then you can see it's also kind of spiraled out like that.
Yeah.
If I'd done it, I was kind of rushed, but if we want to have that propped up a little bit. And so what we can do with that is use some of our other accoutrements to prop it up. So we've got the meat front and center. Humans like things in odd numbers. Mm-hmm. So we're going to use three meats and three cheeses. And then generally when we're looking at, you know, humans eat with their eyes first.
Yes.
Right, so we want to present this the way that humans are going to look at it. So we go from left to right, top to bottom, and then we look in odd numbers. So next I'll put a little bit of the salami, since we're going from left to right and we've got one right in the center, the beef in the center already. I've already pre-sliced everything, which is really helpful to do ahead of time instead of slicing on the board as you're going through. So we'll do kind of a nice pile of the salami down in the bottom left corner. And then I think what I'll do is on the opposite side, do a nice, another, we'll do another shape. You know, this is where the artistic, your artistic flair can come in. We'll do like a little bit of a, we'll call that a salami river. So what's fun with these two salamis and why I selected them, they're kind of our most Ohio salami. First is our number one salami, which is in this yellow package here. It's called number one because it was the first recipe that we decided to launch with.
Right.
And it's mixed with cheese from Blue Jacket Dairy out of Bell Fountain. We chop up fresh sage, garlic, and black pepper for each batch. And then we actually mix in Ohio Debonair Vineyards, their unoaked Chardonnay, as an ingredient in the salami itself. So that's always, we always try to put that on the charcuterie boards when we're making them. Then the dark salami is really unique. It's a collaboration with Wolf's Ridge Brewing, also here in Columbus, Ohio. And we mix in their Dire Wolf, which is a Russian Imperial Stout, and then a custom blend of Mexican mole seasoning from North Market Spices here in Columbus.
Okay, question for you, Duncan.
Yes.
Ideally, you want to serve the meats room temperature.
Yeah, good question. Yeah, good point.
And yes. To bring out the flavor.
Yes.
And if I'm bringing a charcuterie board to my family's Thanksgiving gathering, how long should I allow this to sit out? These are cured meats, so that's one thing. But
yep.
How long should a board
stand? I recommend about 20, 30 minutes ahead of time. Yeah, that's also gonna depend on the time of year, right? So like summertime, if you're going to a picnic, you probably can get away with 10 minutes.
And then how long can it sit out is my question.
Oh, before it spoils?
Yeah.
Well, that's the nice thing about cured meats is technically they won't ever spoil. Cured meats are shelf stable, ready to eat. They don't require refrigeration. You know, so if you're out at a picnic, the meats, they're probably gonna, you know, get warmer, maybe melt a little bit. Some of the fat will come out, but then, you know, all the flavor there is nice to have. And, but yeah, you'll be safe. The cheese might be where you start to get a little bit iffy. A lot of cheeses actually can withstand not being refrigerated for quite a long time. And then some of the other accoutrements that we're gonna put on there, like mustards and everything, you know, again, those can withstand not being refrigerated for quite some time.
Great.
So that's a good question.
So it's the perfect thing to take to an event where you don't have to worry about refrigeration.
Absolutely, yeah. Great. And yeah, great for picnics for sure. All right, so we've got the meats where we want them. Some other things to think about is sort of accessibility. You know, so we've got the meats where we have them, and then if you're going to put cheeses on them, you don't necessarily want to put a cheese, you know, right in the middle of the board because you're going to have a knife in there and using that. So I like to put the cheeses more on the edges, so then when someone brings the knife in, and it's a little bit more accessible. So this cheese here is fun. It's a Gouda from Canal Junction in Northwest Ohio. Then this is called Spotted Owl from Coco Borrego out of Mount Gilead. They actually won an award for a cheese, did a spin on it, put peppercorns in there, and that's a nice addition to the board.
And by the way, for those of you watching, the aromas and the are just amazing with the smoked meats and the cheese.
And then last is a cheddar cheese from Urbanstead Cheese down in Cincinnati, and these are some we've got some really phenomenal Ohio cheesemakers that they're putting out some impressive products. Something that's nice to do with the cheese is sometimes people can be a little hesitant to be the first one to dive in on the cheese. So you can take a fork and then just, you know, cut off a little bit of a piece. And so then we're gonna make like a little bit of a pile there. Then it's a little bit more inviting, so they're not, you know, people aren't uncomfortable being the first person, you know, slicing into the cheese as well.
So we'll
do that for all of these cheeses here. All right, then we've got a lot of flavor in here and a lot of fat as well, which is flavor. But it's nice to add in something that's going to kind of balance out the fat and cut through it, and then so your mouth isn't totally overwhelmed. So it's always a good idea to add in some acidity to the charcuterie board. Two things that we love to put on are our cornichons. You know, just little pickles that you can get at most grocery stores.
Yeah.
You know, we like to shop locally at Weiland's and Hill's Market. So when I'm putting these on, there's something else I'm thinking about is kind of complementing or contrasting colors. You know, so putting some of the greens next to the red meat. These are
I love them.
Oh yeah.
What are they called?
They're called sweet drop peppers.
I love them.
They're a lot of fun.
They
look like
amazing.
They're Yeah, they do taste amazing. They look like they're gonna just light you on fire.
But they don't.
No, they don't. They're really fun. So I like to, so I'll put these kind of, again, next to our salami river. So that'll be a nice red contrast next to the dark of the darkness of the Lupo salami. It's also fun to add some sweetness to the charcuterie board because so much of it, so the cheese and the meat and everything is so salty. We like to partner with local jam makers. So this one's Black Radish Creamery. Some people will, you know, open the jar, take a spoon and like put dots around the board. I find sometimes that can get kind of messy. And since they come in this cute little glass jar, you know, you can just put that on the board like that. Put a spoon in it and you're good to go.
Well, here's the next thing. People don't know what that should go with. So what are you going to do to kind of educate them? Put the crackers there so they know, or?
That's a really good question. So usually when you're assembling things and thinking about pairings is you would put them together.
Yeah.
So I'm glad you called me out on that because this is a blueberry. I didn't think about that. This is a blueberry preserve and I find it goes exceptionally well actually with the street ched. Yeah. So we'll move that one over there. And then yes, we will start to add in the crackers. You know, most people are gonna eat the cheese with the crackers. These are really impressive, made by Weed Knob Bakers out of Westerville. They're called Parmesan Tuscan flatbread crackers. You can get them on our website, northcountrycharcuterie.com, and you can get them from their website too, and across a different stores across the city as well. And one last thing that we're gonna add on, actually I'm gonna put the mustard, we got two more things. We're gonna put mustard, because mustard again is a nice complement to the meats. You know, there's got some of that acidity in there as well. So we'll put that one, we'll put this mustard made by Old Brooklyn Mustard out of Cleveland. Again, put a little spoon in it. These spoons are a little too big, but you know, we're a production facility, so that's what we got. And then last but not least, I'm gonna fill in the board a little bit with these almonds.
Blanched almonds from
Crema Nut Company here in Columbus. And so that's where you can kind of fill, if you've got some gaps in the board that you wanna fill in, you know, to kind of, again, kind of have everything kind of look, you know, you got copious amounts of meats and cheese and everything on there.
But it's kind of nice to see the wood come through too.
I agree,
okay,
yeah. Sometimes less is more.
Yeah.
You're right. And now we're good. I think we're ready to go.
It's just beautiful. And now that I know a little bit more about what charcuterie is, I'm really excited about the competition at the State Fair to see what people come up with. And thank you.
Absolutely,
It's been a real pleasure.
Yeah, thank you so much for coming out. And if you have any more questions about our products or company or how to make a charcuterie board, you can visit northcountrycharcuterie.com or follow us on Instagram as well.
Thank you, and you will be featured on our website as well for more information.
Thank you.